know, have all been enjoying ourselves up to now. And at this point of the night, we come to what I would call the most important part of the evening, because it's the presentation for Father McEvoy, who is leaving for America. That one could come sometime too, I suppose, but he was right under me here, so I couldn't divide the name. If we could have Father McEvoy up on the stage now, and Father Carter was called out there for a minute, so as soon as Father Carter comes back in, we'll start with the presentation. Now we're back here again, and as I said, the most important part of the evening. And I'm not going to say any more to you now, because you're tired listening to me, so I will call on Father Carter here to make the presentation of this wallet. And what's inside in it is a draft for the total amount collected, by the way, was £1,240.80. And inside the wallet is a draft for £1,202.80. So I call on Father Carter now to make a presentation on behalf of the parishioners of Raheen to Father McEvoy.
It gives me great pleasure to make this presentation to Father Frank here. We worked together for about upwards of 6 months. I remember last February when Father Peter Riley went off to hospital, and we were expecting him back again. But he went off and had an examination up in the hospital, Elm Park, and he was not allowed to come back. So then we had to get somebody else, and I was wondering who we were going to get, and eventually it became known that Father McEvoy was coming along. And I didn't know much about him and what he was going to be like. So we were hoping for the best. And then he came along, and we were very impressed, and I think you were too. And as he came and walked amongst us, we got on very well together, and he got on very well with you. In a short space of time, he made a big impact on the parish and on the people. And we grew to like his ways and himself. And it's a token of his popularity that so many people have turned up here tonight, and that you have responded so well to give him a send-off. I didn't think there was so much money in the parish of Raheen. Songs from various cities throughout the world, including tulips from Amsterdam and so on, songs associated with the cities, and amongst them was New Orleans. So it said, I was wondering, did you hear the father? No. No. He wasn't up. But that's it, anyway, it'll be a few more songs now when he goes out there. We'll have a few fresh ones. Well, again, well, we won't keep you too long. I, on your behalf, then, I would like to make this presentation to Father Frank. We were very sorry to lose him, but the only redeeming feature about it all was that we got a very nice man in this place.
Thank you. too early. I can ramble on and say Mass and have time to myself to think. And usually when we were students, we were always asked to, you know, we were supposed to do some meditation or some prayer. I was just thinking back when I first thought about becoming a priest. And that was way back when I was only 17 years of age. And I remember being on a vocations weekend in Carlow, and the Brotherhood of Man had a song out then. It was the Eurovision Song Contest. I think the name of it was Save All Your Kisses For Me, but that isn't quite. But there was one part in that, the one part of the song goes that there's only one thing I have to say before I go, and that is, I love you. That is true of me here tonight. I loved you. I love being with you. And if you like, I don't really like leaving you, but I have made my decision and I want to stand by it. And I always remember that, like John the Baptist, I must decrease and Father Murphy must increase. Thank you very much.
Well, Reverend Fathers, ladies and gentlemen, we have a few more presentations to make to Father Murphy. And I don't know why I said Father Murphy. It's a great name anyhow, I must say that. And it's a great Wexford name. So I've been embarrassed saying it, but I can't help it, you know. But Father McEvoy, anyhow. And I'll be killed now, you know, for making all these mistakes, but that's just how it is, you know. And Father McEvoy is a great sportsman, and he took a great interest in the Cork GAA club. And I can't help thinking that I don't know what we're going to do when they play the final, because we had hoped to play the final before he left for America. And I can't help thinking that on the last two matches that they played, against Mount Benick and against Slea Bloom, two teams that I say they were a little bit afraid going out to hurl. But Father McEvoy was in the dressing room before they went out, and he must have said a few prayers for them, I'm sure, because they went out and they hurled like devils. And they won the matches. And now we're in the final, in the intermediate final, and I hope that he'll be playing as hard as he can in New Orleans when they're out. I think it's the 22nd of September they'll be playing the final. So I hope that he'll be praying and that he'll get Father Murphy to say a few prayers as well. Because from now on, we have to depend on Father Murphy. And I noticed, I was in his house the other evening, and I couldn't help seeing that he has a little hurley stick. So I'm sure he'll be coming along to the Cork club. In fact, he has been there already, and I hope to see him in the colours in 1985. So without any further ado, I want to call on George Dalton, the chairman of the Colts Hurling Club, to make a presentation on behalf of the Colts GAA.
Father McEvoy, Father Carter, Father Murphy, and Father Lawler, ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the Colts Hurling Club, I want to thank Father McEvoy here for his encouragement all the year, and I suppose we started the beginning of the year at a low ebb, and he came into the field, he was with all the lads there, and he was in the dressing room, as Dick said, and last two matches, and we were looking forward to having him in the dressing room before the final, even though he'd left the parish, and well, now the final is postponed, and he'll be 3,000 miles away, but I know he'll be thinking of us, and I suppose, as he said himself there, that we should think of him, and even when we go home tonight, maybe we should say a little prayer for him. But on behalf of the Cork Club, I make this presentation. Thanks very much.
Ahead of him, and I remember him wearing the Wexford jersey, As I feel if Wexford hadn't beaten Kilkenny, Kilkenny would have beaten Cork. But anyhow, Mrs. Senna, don't worry about that. But I wasn't much of a sportsman. I don't in college. I played a lot of soccer in the seminary and football. But as for hurling, I hadn't much of an idea. And when I came here, the lads asked me to go and play with them. And I learned a little bit about it. And later in the night, they asked me, was I bringing the hurley with me to America? And I told them I had the golf clubs and the squash racket and the tennis racket, but I wasn't sure what to do with the hurley. But I think I will bring it with me because it's always a reminder to me of your kindness. And above all, I want to say one thing of your respect for me. I always felt that even though I gave maybe the odd wrong push and that, you never seemed to correct me about it. And I think it was out of respect for me as a priest. And I think that meant a lot to me, and it should mean a lot to me to think that you think that much of a priest. And also, and I referred to it before here in the parish, that I remember you using holy water before you went out. And again, I think it's a wonderful thing to see that even in sports, we mix religion. And I'd like to wish them the best of luck, and I will think of you on that. I'll be 6 hours behind you in time, but I'd probably be maybe around 1:30 or that maybe siesta time, I don't know. But I'll be thinking of you anyhow, whichever way to be, and I wish you the best of luck, and thanks very much for your kindness.
Just that I was reading on the paper today, just reading Abelique's notes, where
Nancy herself was looking for some new members, and I think it might be no harm maybe if the younger ladies, maybe younger wives also, decided to join, because I think they're a wonderful organisation their own way. And it's an opportunity for the wives to get away from the husbands for a while, which is no harm.
Reverend Father, ladies and gentlemen, that concludes the presentations. But just one announcement that I want to make is that the Cayley and all-time dancing classes that we had here last year are starting again on tomorrow night week, Friday week. So I hope to see all the faces that we had before and new ones as well. This is Cayley and all-time, and it's nice, I think, to see the all-time dancing and the Cayley dancing coming back again.
Gentlemen, children, somebody mentioned there about a half day, whether we'd have to consult the teachers first of all, of course. We couldn't give it here on the stage often without consulting the teachers. But tomorrow anyhow is Friday. So we'll see about next week. We couldn't do anything about tomorrow.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
enjoying yourselves up to now, and at this point of the night, we come to what I would call the most important part of the evening, because it's the presentation for Father McEvoy, who is leaving for America. That one could come sometime too, I suppose, but he was right under me here, so I couldn't divide the name. If we could have Father McEvoy up on the stage now, and Father Carter was called out there for a minute, so as soon as Father Carter comes back in, we'll start with the presentation. As I said, the most important part of the evening. And I'm not going to say any more to you now, because you're tired listening to me. So I will call on Father Carter here to make the presentation of this wallet. And what's inside in it is a draft for the total amount collected, by the way, was £1,240.80. Inside the wallet is a draft for £1,202.80. So I call on Father Carter now to make the presentation on behalf of the parishioners of Raheen to Father McEvoy.
And ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to make this presentation to Father Frank here. We worked together for about upwards of 6 months. I remember last February when Father Peter Riley went off to hospital and we were expecting him back again. But he went off and had an examination up in the hospital, Ellen Park. And he was not allowed to come back. So then we had to get somebody else, and I was wondering who we were going to get, and eventually it became known that Father McEvoy was coming along. And I didn't know much about him and what he was going to be like. So we were hoping for the best. And then he came along, and we were very impressed, and I think you were too. And as he came and walked amongst us, we got on very well together. And he got on very well with you. In a short space of time, he made a big impact on the parish and on the people, and regrew to life his ways and himself. And it's a token of his popularity that so many people have turned up here tonight, and that you have responded so well to give him a send-off. I didn't think there was so much money in the parish of Raheen. Derek Davis was on, and he had a program on songs from various cities throughout the world, including Tulips from Amsterdam and so on, songs associated with the cities, and amongst them was New Orleans. So it said, I was wondering, did you hear Father? No. He wasn't up. But that's it, anyway, it'll be a few more songs now when he goes out there. We'll have a few fresh ones. Well, again, well, we won't keep you too long. On your behalf, then, I would like to make this presentation to Father Frank. We were very sorry to lose him, but the only redeeming feature about it all was that we got a very nice man in this place.
Oh,